Time Wizard, and this is my video on my gear. And I'm making a video rather than just posting pictures, because obviously I can talk and tell, and it's easier than typing. And I already have the camera set up because I was doing those other maintenance videos for this. So, yeah. Fuck it, I'm gonna do it live.
So I'll start with my weapons.
My weapon, my primary weapon is the VTEC G36 or G39 C gas blowback rifle. I love it. It's gas blowback, so I don't carry much ammunition on me, but it's totally worth it. There's nothing better than getting down to your last few mags and you know you still have to go on for another, well, however long you have to go on before you run out. It just gets more desperate, more adrenaline there. On my WeTech G39C, I have a couple additions, a couple things I like to have. First thing is my wolf hook. It attaches to right here. It lets me, you know, it's like a sling. Plenty of movement. I can lock the stock forward. Still use it. It doesn't restrict me at all. Stopped me from shooting left-handed, but I'm a terrible shot left-handed anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But the important part is I can drop it, and it doesn't do anything. I can just set it here, pull out my sidearm. Really, theoretically, I can get away with running a shotgun and then shooting this, too. It just lets you use your hands to climb ladders, open doors, punch people in the face. Whatever you need to do. That's why I like it. Next thing I use is the, you should be able to see it pretty good, the flaming pig there, the Noveski flash hider. I like the way it looks. This is the one that supposedly makes your gun louder too, or directs your noise downrange. This gun's already loud, and anything I can do to try to make it louder is more better. Yeah. I also use a expensive like flashlight on a set of cheap scope mounts. Places my thumb right where I need it to be, or if I'm not using it, I can hold this. And that's also the MagPul angled foregrip. It's very comfortable. I like that a lot too. Lets me hold it in a nice solid grip. I don't recommend holding your magazine or your gun like this. This is better. The further out towards the end of your gun, the better. So they say. So, or I can turn it on all the time. It's just a very nice gun, and that's how I like it set up. Next thing I have is my KWA M9 PTP. Double action, holds 25 rounds or something, 30 rounds in the magazine. I don't load it up that much because it usually doesn't like to fire all of them with the gas. Very nice. I use it because I had it on rec, and then I have this tether on it. Same one I used in Iraq. Some people say that they never would use this. They don't see a point, but it's not to keep your pistol from falling on the ground. It's to let you know that your pistol's dragging behind you. Otherwise, you could easily lose $160 worth of airsoft pistol off in the woods or somewhere else. Doesn't really matter. That's what it's for. It's to make sure you know if you lose it. And with this elastic thing I have, I can pretty much, you know, shoot in any direction. It doesn't restrict me at all. So that's what I like about it. Now I'll talk about the vest. I've got this. It's a kind of an admin pouch, shotgun gun pouch. Gives me some Velcro to put awesome patches on. A flashlight holder for that one that's now on the mount, in case I ever wanted to be awesome and just hold my flashlight. This is a Condor outdoor vest. I chose it because it's the only one that I found that will hold the G36 mags. Easily, successively. It holds six. I have three more past that. On this side, I've got three M9 mags, you can see. I'm gonna move them to my offhand side soon, just haven't done it yet. Down on my leg, you can see the actual holster I carried my M9 in Iraq with two more M9 mags. It's got three pouches there that I carry two mags down in. Usually one of these mags can go in the rifle mag. In terms of other gear, I have a belt on, and then I have a drop pouch. Very important for any sort of thing where you have low cap magazines, because it's the fastest place to ditch your mags when you have to reload, like in this. Oops, put that in the pouch backwards. I'm not perfect at it, but it's very useful. If you have time, of course, ideally, you might slide an empty bag back in there, because this is going to get really heavy when you have even three or four of these heavy gas mags. Next thing I'd recommend is a pair of gloves, obviously. We all have been shot in there.
My face, I have an
actual mesh mask. Covers the ears, covers the lower face. My giant forehead is just a big target though. I have a pair of goggles, wherever they went. My eye protection is a pair of ESS V12 goggles. I got sunglass lenses for them too, and that's what I want. They fit here. It's a nice fit. They don't hardly fog up unless I'm camping or, I don't know. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Usually just shaking my head or moving takes care of that problem. But obviously, still the giant forehead. I'd wear a hat, but in the summer it's too hot. Another weapon I have, and you probably saw if you were there the other day, is this shotgun. My friend was using it. I like it a lot. I didn't get the chance to use it because I got caught up in using my G39, which is way more awesome, actually. It's a multi-shot shotgun. I can easily carry my shotgun shells here. I have about 20. Now you can just go in the drop pouch. It's really easy. If there's one thing that I like to have, it's plenty of ammo, especially when I'm using low caps. If I could, I'd have 19 of these gas G36 mags, and they'd be all over the place. But at that point, that's probably like $1,000 worth of magazines. Well, at least $700. And that's probably the reason why nobody uses gas blowback rifles yet. I don't know if there's anything else. I should get a rubber knife and put it someplace awesome. But right now, the end of my gun works good enough for knife kills. So, hopefully I'll see you around, and that's all I've got.
Hi there, I'm Wizard, and I just wanted to show you what your G39 will look like if you put 9 mags together.
It's not very practical, and it weighs a freaking ton. But it looks awesome. Yeah. Alrighty then.